we fought a revolution in the name of certain beliefs, of liberty, of justice for all, of self-rule and self-reliance. There are many in this country who feel we have not yet won that war.
Fewer and fewer of us are voting. More and more of us are joining the ranks of a resistance.
The bailout is intrinsically hyperinflationary. The only reason that anybody in their right mind would even think of supporting this bill is because they're scared. And we need a Gideon's army to pull through the reform. And some of you are biblical scholars, you know what I'm talking about. You have to take all the people who are cowards, who will not step up to the plate, as they say, on this issue, and say, okay, dear coward, we're taking over. We're leading. Now, the danger here, of course, is that you're going to have a French Revolution problem, as I said, inside the United States. You now have, and some of these idiots, and even my friendly friends out there, who say, please, please be cautious, let this bill go through so they won't shoot us. That's what they're saying. They're saying that behind the Bush administration, there are people who would actually use U.S. troops to shoot down people who want to oppose this bill. That's there right now. That is reality. And that's what some of these questions are reflecting. There are people in high places, including some very high-ranking people in terms of their background, who agree totally with what I say about this stuff, but they won't fight because they say, we'll be shot. We don't want to go into a death camp. Well, if we go into a death camp because we do this, the world will never forgive those who do it. And the world will never forgive those who capitulate to this. Anybody who's smart is not going to take on the American people in that fashion. You're not going to shove a dictatorship down the throat of the American people. They'll kill you. They'll kill you. And they can. Learn the lesson of Vietnam and a few other locations. They will kill you, and they can, if you make them angry enough. And you're about to make them very angry. The reason you're getting such a peculiar behavior in the House of Representatives background is because the people out there who are behind the people who voted against this bill, those people out there are ready to kill. Not because they're killers, but because they see the destruction of everything that life means to them is threatening them. They've seen a lot of it, step by step. They've put up with it. They've accepted it. They've crawled for it. They said, we have to get along. We have to get along. The time has come when they know that everything is being taken away from them, and that was too much. You're going to find the rage against the White House and against the Senate, in particular, is going to escalate in ways during the coming days of this week and next week, in ways beyond anything most of you believe. I can see it right there. It's there. It's coming. The mood in the American people, having gone through fake wars, they've had their children sent out into fake wars, like Iraq. It was a fake war. We don't need to go there. No need to get into that war. Then they got into it, they made a mess of it, even what they started. No need. Look at the suffering of people who went in service, come back from that war, not only the death, but injuries. But they can't get help. They're condemned to horrible conditions. And in every neighborhood in the United States, there's someone in that category. It radiates. Don't you see the hatred you're building up against Washington in the people of the United States? And this bill is one bill too many. You're headed for something like the French Revolution, and you're going to bring it on your own heads if you're dumb enough not to fight. Not to fight. There is no remedy. There is no excuse for supporting this bill. None. There is no moral excuse for voting.
There's millions of us waiting to take up arms, ready to spread the word.
How was that, Mom? How was that? Was that fun?
I said, he's going to draw me. First again, I'm going to shoot him in the toodles.